Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will review the enhancements that have been made for viewing and retrieving deployed message flows and applications. The enhancements were added in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12.0.9. So I'm showing the App Connect Enterprise documentation page. Here it shows the enhancements that we've added in 12.09, and in this page you can see the enhancements that we've made for viewing and retrieving message flows and applications. We first added the capability in 12.0.8, and we've added three videos after 12.0.8 was released, which you can see here in the YouTube channel. And so in this video, I'm going to describe the different pieces of capability. So I'm going to start with showing the enhancements for viewing deployed message flows. So in 12.08, we added capability where you could either right-click on a deployed message flow or double-click on the deployed message flow, and it would show the message flow that was deployed. So you could see the flow in the flow editor, you could see the sticky notes, if there were any. It would show the flow level properties, it'd also show endpoints, and it would show the live values for the individual nodes as well. And this was handy for allowing a person to understand what the deployed message flow was being used for, and it also allowed you to check what the overridden values were for individual node properties. So in 12.0.9, we've enhanced this capability so that you can now view message flows that were deployed as CMF, which means compiled message flow. And you can also view message flows which have been migrated from version 10 and earlier. So these types of flows were not available to be viewed in 12.08, but you can now view them in 12.09. The flows are shown in the format where the label is shown underneath the icon, and this is done to be consistent with the older versions of the product. Note that subflows cannot currently be viewed when you're viewing the message flow. So let's do a demonstration. So I have my toolkit here and I have several applications deployed. This particular application, transformation_ESQL, it has a message flow which was deployed with a CMF. And if I now right click and select view message flow, the flow is shown. And you can see a sticky note is also added so that it confirms that the message flow has been generated from the CMF file. You are still able to see the flow properties. You're able to see the endpoint information. So this is using an HTTP input node, and I can see the URI which is being used. And I can also click on individual message flow nodes and I can see the node properties. So these are the live node properties which are being used. So in addition to being able to now see CMF flows, you're also able to see migrated flows. So I have an integration node that was migrated from version 10, and in there I have an application with a flow. If I double click on that message flow, I can now see this flow, and it informs me in a sticky note that the message flow was generated from a DFM XML file. So when message flows are migrated from version 10 to version 11 or version 12, the flows are deployed as .dfm XML. That's just an internal representation, but you are now able to view these flows. And as before, you can see the flow properties, you can see the endpoint information, and you can click on individual nodes to see the node properties. So the other piece of capability that we have enhanced is being able to retrieve source artifacts. So we're able to allow you to retrieve source artifacts in 12.08. This was useful for a number of reasons. It might be that the original source is missing from your source control system. You might want to allow your fellow team members to collaborate and connect to a shared integration server, and they may want to retrieve a source in order to debug the flow to find out where any issues might be. You're able to view the content in nodes like compute nodes and mapping nodes by retrieving the flow. And it aids migration now, because new in 1209, you can now retrieve artifacts which were migrated from version 10 and earlier. We also now allow you to retrieve message flows that were deployed to CMF. So if you have a CMF flow, then you can retrieve the application and it is retrieved as a message flow. Previously in 1208, you were not able to do this. This also allows you to redeploy the application to another server, so that if you need to replicate a problem that you're debugging elsewhere and you cannot get the original bar file, then you can retrieve the application and set breakpoints and deploy it to another integration server for debugging. The retrieve wizard has been enhanced in 1209. It's now a three-step wizard. The first step shows you a list of applications where you have to select one of the applications. You can now right click on an individual application and launch the wizard, and that application will be pre-selected in this list. The second panel is divided into three lists. The top list shows policy projects which are deployed. If the selected application has flows which are referencing policies, then the policy projects that contain those policies will be automatically selected for you. If you want to select other policy projects, then you can choose an alternative radio button and then select the other policies. It also shows the list of any reference shared libraries in the middle part of a panel, and at the bottom of a panel it shows any static libraries that are included. And then finally, in the third panel, it shows a list of the application resources which will be imported. After you click finish, the resources are then shown in the workspace. New in 1209, we are now allowing you to retrieve an application that contains message flows that are compiled. So you may have a bar file which had been built with the option compile and inline resources, and if you did, then the bar would contain CMF files and would deploy them as CMF. So in 1209, you can now retrieve those applications and those CMF files will be converted to message flow. A sticky note will also be added to indicate that it was generated from the CMF file. The message flow format will be in the format where the node label is below the icon to be consistent with previous releases of ACE. And as I said earlier, you're now able to retrieve applications which were migrated from version 10 and earlier. So a flow that was migrated from version 10 to version 11 or version 12, then the message flow would have been deployed as .dfmxml. So these sorts of applications could not be retrieved fully in 1208, but in 1209 you can now retrieve those applications, and the .dfmxml files are converted to message flows. And a sticky note is shown in the flow to indicate that the message flow was generated from the .dfmxml file. And it also means that if you have any configurable services that were migrated from version 10 to version 12, then those configurable services can be imported into your workspace using the policy project that was migrated to, and so you can now see the policies as policy XML files in your workspace. Also in 1209, we are now allowing you to retrieve an application where the message flow has Java compute nodes which are using Java files. In 1208, you were not able to retrieve the application fully. You could not retrieve the Java files, but in 1209, you can. After retrieving the application, the Java compute node will be using the Java file that was added in the workspace. The .java source classes will not be retrieved, so only the Java files will be in the workspace. If you do double click on the Java compute node in the message flow, then you'll be shown a warning to say that this will create the new Java projects, and you will need to then find the original Java files and add them into that Java project so that they can be used in the Java compute node. Without that, it will use the .jars as is, and you will be able to deploy that application to a different server, and when you do, it will also deploy the .jar file. So let's demo some of these things. So I have an application here which is using shared libraries. If I do retrieve and import resource on the application is selected on the first page. If I click next, the shared libraries which I referenced are shown. And if I click next, it shows what will be imported. And after clicking finish, the application is added into the workspace and it contains the references to the shared libraries. So in this case, it's using some chained shared libraries and all the references are added automatically. If I have an application that is using a flow which is referencing a policy, then when I launch the wizard, the second page will show the policy project selected automatically. I can optionally select the second radio button and select the other policy project which was not referenced in this case. But if I don't want it, then I can go back to the first radio button and leave that selected so that the reference policy project is brought in. So when I click next, you can see the flow and the policy project that will be retrieved. And if I click finish, the application is retrieved along with the policy project. New in 12.09, you are now able to retrieve an application that has message flows which are deployed as CMF. So remember, this message flow is deployed as CMF. I can now select the application and do retrieve. And when I click next, it will show the resource that's going to be retrieved. And after clicking finish, you can see that the application has been retrieved and the flow has been generated as a message flow from the CMF file. So if I double click for message flow, you can see there's a sticky note which says that the flow was generated from the CMF. If I try and retrieve an application that was migrated, where the flow is deployed as DFM XML, I can again right click on the application and do retrieve and import resource. And when I go through the wizard, I can see that it's going to import the DFM XML file. And when I click finish, I can see that the application now contains a message flow which was generated from the DFM XML file. If you have an application where it is using Java, you are now able to retrieve this in 12.09. I can right click and do retrieve and import resource of the application, and it shows the jar file that will be imported. If I click finish, the application is imported along with the jar file. The toolkit understands that the flow is using the jar file and there will be no build issues because it is using the jar file. If you do double click on the node, then it will warn you that it will create a new Java project. So it would need the Java source files to be added to the project. As well as being able to retrieve the source applications, we've also added capability where you can now retrieve a bar file from the deployed application. So you can right click on the application and select retrieve bar, and the bar will be generated from the deployed application. So if I select this application here, MRM app, this has a dictionary and XSD zip. So these artifacts cannot be retrieved. And when you try and retrieve the source, you will see a warning which says that those file types cannot be retrieved and imported. If you select the checkbox to continue to import anyway, then it will only retrieve those artifacts that it can retrieve. So it will retrieve the message flow, the library and ESQL, but the XSD zip and dictionary will not be imported. So if I click finish there, you can see that the application will not contain the dictionary or XSD zip. This warning here, which shows that the application contains static library, is showing if it's including a static library, and you have to manually add the reference to the static library. If I open the application, then you can see the flow is only in the application and the SQL, the actual XSD zip and dictionary is not there. But if I retrieve the bar file, then the bar can be imported. If it already exists, then you have the option to overwrite it. And so when you retrieve it, you're given a link to the bar file, and this will be contained in the generated bar files folder, and the bar file will contain the dictionary and XSD zip. And you can take this bar file and deploy it to another integration server, and you will see that the deployed application will contain the dictionary and XSD zip. So this is a neat way to being able to retrieve a bar from a deployed application. We've also provided a new import wizard, which allows you to import source projects from a bar file. So if a bar file has been built with the option to add workspace project source files into the bar file, then you can now import those projects from the bar file. If I show an example of this, if I right click and do import and select import projects from a bar file, click next, and if I browse to my folder which contains my bar files and select the bar file which I know has source in it, the source projects are listed in here, and then I can click finish and the application is retrieved. In this video I've shown several enhancements which have been provided in 12.09. Message flows that were deployed as CMF can now be viewed. Message flows that were migrated from version 10 and earlier to version 12 can also be viewed. You can retrieve an application that contains CMF message flows, so they are compiled message flows. You can retrieve an application that was migrated to version 12. You can retrieve a bar file from a deployed application. And if you have a bar file that contains source, you can import projects from that bar file.